2019. Cutting a what was an orchard grass alfalfa field, had a lot of alfalfa. First cut, weather had prevented me from doing this earlier in the year. And what I am noticing is we have had very optimal cool season grass weather. Grass is like orchard grass. Orchard grass is completely, I think, displaced the alfalfa. It's really hard to even see any alfalfa left in this stand. And then there's some kind of bare patches. I wouldn't say bare, but patches where the orchard grass is not as tall. And there's big patches of crown vetch in there. I planted this field about 10 years ago. There's a patch of crown vetch down there, and it kind of really smothers, has a smothering effect on anything else. Right there, there's a patch of crown vetch. Okay. Crown vetch is brought in and planted along roadsides. Kind of like when they're planting and reclaiming road project areas, they want to put ground cover over the field. A lot of times you use that creeping red fescue and crown vetch. So there's another patch of crown vetch, but it's completely displaced the alfalfa. And in this field, when I first, I baled it for a couple years before I plowed it up, did a clear seeding of alfalfa, and it had a lot of crown vetch and bluegrass in it. And the crown vetch does not tolerate grazing or cutting very good. So it will, you can eliminate it that way pretty easy. However though, it does seem to compete well with an overstory canopy of, you know, a thick mat of grass. It came in here where this orchard grass is, and it wasn't here when this was a really thick mat of bluegrass. But the alfalfa just did. There, crown vetch. That crown vetch really gets low to the ground, but it does have a smothering effect. You know, cows eat the crown vetch, but boy, it's hard stuff to grow. Hard. So, what I'm hoping for here is that because I've got a lot of straw from the first cutting orchard grass, is even though we have pretty cold temperatures, we're only highs in the 50s right now. We have a whole week of not a lot of rain, but mostly sunny weather forecast. And they did say 40% chance of rain Tuesday, Wednesday. So if we don't get a lot of rain Tuesday or Wednesday, I think I can actually get this dry. Enough to bail. Be some good cow hay. Get another patch of ground vetch. And it does have a smothering effect, but thought interesting observation. It's almost like, where's the alfalfa? It really does not compete well, and apparently there must be quite a seed bank of this crown vetch in here. I don't see hairy vetch be this competitive. I do see hairy vetch once in a while in some of my fields. It doesn't really smother other stuff out. It just climbs up more on the grasses and grows, you know, more up like a vine. This crown vetch wants to grow close to the ground and strangles everything out. So, all right, we'll see if we can get this dry.
This is cow hay here. This is worth cow hay. Okay.
this year, really not much weeds. And you can't tell me any of you wouldn't want to drink cows if you're great. So, yeah, this is the fruit cow in here. Beautiful fall weather. Colors are starting to come in. Another 7-acre field. This should be the last hay that I cut of the year. It's the same thing in this field. Crown benches all over the place. Didn't see them at all in the previous year. This field actually is a field I usually square bale if I get to it. It's not that bad a day. But maybe this season, because of cool, wet growing conditions, it just was so good for the cool season grasses that, you know, alfalfa couldn't compete. I don't know. You know, I'd say legumes, but, you know, the crown benches of legumes, it seems to be competing just fine. There's actually some of it still flowering in this field. There's some flowering right there. I'll try to get a better shot of that. And autumn olive bushes growing in the field. Autumn olive is amazing how it can compete. It can come in a grass sod, and you know, I've been cutting this field every year, and that autumn olive comes up and seeds in this thick stuff. And then there's another pair, there's a spot where it's crown benches in there. It's flowering. Look at all that autumn olive.